Hey, it's Ravyn Lenae, and we're chatting about my new album, Bird's Eye. This album means so much to me because I'm retracing my steps, going back home, realizing how much family and Chicago and my path so far has dictated a lot of my decisions and my journey so far. I think it was important for me to retrace my steps, go home, and really think about the moments in my childhood, in my teenagehood that made me who I am and solidified early stages of me identifying myself. A lot of the music focuses on family relationships, personal growth, me turning 25 and being unsure about my position in the world. But looking at all of this in the lens of my journey being beautiful, with the mistakes, with the stumbles, and with the triumphant moments. So I think looking at these very human moments and instances from a broader perspective has helped me, I don't know, acknowledge where I'm at and be okay with that. There's a part of me that has returned to my first feelings and first like flutters about music and about being creative. And that's down to maybe the way I express myself with clothes, with my hair, with music, and really embracing all of my influences was important for me during this time. So I was looking at a lot of like pictures of myself when I was like 12 and the things I was wearing and remembering how fearless and unapologetic I was during those stages of my life and wanting to really bring that into where I'm at now and in the music. So there's something so fun about returning to that stage of, I don't know, following your impulse and not really questioning it. So a lot of the songs came from that, and I don't know, not being scared to break rules or feel young in that way again. There's a picture of me when I'm 12 and I have on like this kind of tutu Hot Topic skirt with like some jeans underneath. So just this mashing of worlds is something that was really interesting to me and wanted to showcase through, you know, the music and like vocally. I think the song that resonates the most with me today would be Dream Girl, only because I feel like it scratches all parts of my brain and touches on a lot of the music I grew up listening to. So that one feels special for me. One of my biggest influences is Janet Jackson. So having a song that reminds me of that world is everything I've ever wanted. And also having Jimmy Jam himself play on it is such an honor. So that'll forever be a memorable moment for me. Preteen me with the Hot Topic skirt and the jeans underneath would definitely identify with One of One. That one feels the most just free, loud, really like annoying in the best way. I have a lot of feelings. I'm gonna let it out. I don't care what this feels like, what this sounds like. So that one is one of my favorites because of that. This process of making the album was very, I wanna say communal. Dahi, who executive produced the album, really served as an anchor for just the soundscape of where I was traveling. You know, I learned so much from him. A lot of his process requires really leaning on your impulses and really leaning on what feels instinct, really. So I feel like I learned a lot about not overthinking, not second guessing, going with what feels good. So a lot of the process was me just following that, and it felt so easy because of that. I'm very protective of the process and how many opinions I let kind of sink into what's happening. So I'm just very sensitive to outside noise. And I realized that with Hypnose. So with this one, I wanted to be careful about, I don't know how much I let those outside voices kind of creep in. I think with every project, I learn a little bit more about what I like, what I dislike, what I need to feel inspired. With Hypnos, I knew I learned that I was very sensitive to opinions. And that's something I'm learning to kind of like not affect me, but I don't know if I can. Beyond that though, I think I learned to not overthink too much about the direction I'm going in and to just do what feels good. I think with Hypnos, I placed a lot of rules on myself of what it had to feel like, what it had to sound like, who had to be involved. And I kind of freed myself of that with this album. So I think Hypnos and Bird's Eye are sisters. I think Bird's Eye is a more rambunctious sister who just kind of does what she wants whenever she wants it, wants to, where Hypnos, I guess, is more subdued, more quiet. I think I had to push past those boundaries of placing rules on Hypnos. I think because I had no other choice. If I wanted to continue to grow and to explore new parts of myself and new parts of music, I really had no other choice but to kind of alleviate myself of these pressures and expectations. Otherwise, I don't think I would have an album right now. I knew I was making this album over a year ago when I had my first session with Dahi. I just knew there was something special between us, and the chemistry just felt very obvious for me. So I think after that first session, I texted my manager and was like, I need to do it with Dahi and nobody else. And I'm happy he felt that way too. Dahi is a songwriter. Dahi has a lot of influence over, I don't know, Dahi just knows. So there'll be times where I would sing melodies and like I would overthink it, and he'd be like, it was the first one. I don't know why you're tripping. Like, it was the first one. So having someone in the room like him to be able to bounce ideas off of and him kind of validate me and my gift, you know, was important for me. And then I've collaborated with my friend Sarah Ahrens. We did a lot of co-writing together on the project. And working with her, I learned so much about songwriting and like fell in love with it like all over again. Yeah, and just understanding how important it is to really peel back those layers and say exactly what you mean. I think this album is a pivotal moment for me in my process and my relationship with music, because I think I just broke a lot of those barriers down that I had been carrying. And I think moving forward, it can only get more free, more natural, more fun. I want fans to listen to Bird's Eye and get a better understanding of who I am, where I come from, the things that have made me who I am, and see themselves in that. Creating Bird's Eye was fun for me, because I kind of got to use my imagination and travel back to when I was 12, when I was 15, when I was 18, and being able to come home physically and be in my old bedroom, be in my grandmother's basement, really made me think about where I've come from, how far I've come, and the steps it's taken to get to where I am, and be proud of that. Like, the older we get, the more we kind of get disconnected from that. So going back home and like even listening to the music back home, looking at old pictures, like, that's what transports me, you know.